My name is Joachim Hessel. I'm the managing director of Hessel Ingenieurtechnik. We are located in Rüttgen, which is a small village in Germany. I have the pleasure to present the current results of Work Package 4, Development of Flaw Acceptance Criteria, which is a part of a European project called Development and Validation of an Automatic Non-Destructive Evaluation Approach for Testing Welded Joints and Plastic Pipes. An abbreviation of this is TestPEP, like the logo says. The contents of this presentation is to show you some results of creep rupture tests on butt welds, contaminated and not contaminated. Also creep rupture test results on corks, machined from electrofusion joints. The third point is to show you the results of the internal pressure tests on pipes with electrofusion couplers. And at the end, I would like to give you an idea how the flaws can be evaluated by using the results of the mechanical tests. In this slide, the test setup for the creep rupture testing of butt welds is described. We are doing these tests according to EN standard mentioned. The test specimen, which is machined from the pipe, is placed between two clamps in the equipment. We have a test bath which contains the test fluid. We are testing at elevated temperatures to reduce the test time. We have a pump which is pumping the test fluid through the pipe bath, through the test bath, and to mixture the test fluid. The specimen is loaded by a constant load, which is guaranteed by a constant load, gravity, and transferred through a lever arm by a lever arm to the test specimen. And at the end of the test, the rupture time is recorded. The typical failure of PE butt welded joints for all the range of polyethylene quality is shown in this slide. Here we have the lowest quality, which is named PEHD without any additional requirements. We have the next step of quality, which is called PE80, and then we have PE100 existing since 30 years, and the highest quality of polyethylene is PE100RC. All four qualities can be butt welded, and if they are put in a tensile creep rupture equipment under constant load, as described before, we have the failure starting at the notches between the bead and the parent material. The dotted line in these pictures is the fusion level. You clearly can see that the failure is outside the fusion level. These pictures are from previous investigations which are supporting the current TestPEP project. Now we have the failure appearance of the welds without flaws from this project, and it's identical to the knowledge from the previous investigations. We have in all cases the starting point of the crack at the notch between the bead and the parent material. And all the cracks, all the failure is outside the fusion plane, which is indicated by this dotted line. Here we have a diagram which shows us the rupture times of this reference specimens. The yellow bar is a yellow pipe, and the black, blue and red are P100 resins, and the pipe made from P80 has a rupture time around 56 hours. So the rupture times of the reference specimens under these accelerating conditions are reasonable to be used in the project. When we go to contaminated welds, in this case contaminated by talc, we can observe a completely different fracture behavior of the welds. We have the fracture not beginning at the notch between the bead and the parent material, but inside the fusion zone, and the welded areas are very poor. The difference between the contaminated welds and the uncontaminated welds is that the fracture of the contaminated welds are inside the fusion plane. To put all the results in one diagram, we used the rupture times of the contaminated welds related to the rupture time of the uncontaminated welds, and the uncontaminated weld is 100%. The tendency of all curves is that the rupture time decreases with the with the level of contamination at all welds. Now we come to the tests on the corks. These are parts machined from the electrofusion joints. First, we have to prepare these specimens from the joints. And here you see a joint after removing the specimens for the tensile creep rupture tests. The black part is a coupler, and the blue part inside is a pipe. This is a cork, like a cork in a wine bottle, similar, machined from the electrofusion joint. We have this black color, the part of the cork from the coupler. The blue part is from the pipe. And in between, we have the wires which are responsible to transfer the heat in the electrofusion joint. The cork is a relatively small piece, and if we want to perform tensile creep rupture tests, we have to weld extension bars by butt welding to this cork. In this slide you can see the three steps of preparation. First, we are machining the cork, then we butt weld the extension bars and we get a pre-test specimen. And to get a defined cross-section for this region, we use a lathe and machine this final specimen. This specimen is put, like the butt welds, also in the test equipment for tensile creep rupture tests. We have the same test equipment. We have a constant load which produces a constant stress at the beginning of the test. When the test is finished, we can distinguish two sorts of failure. The first failure can be in the wire plane. The wire plane is a weak point in the joint because the copper wires do not transfer the load between the surrounding polyethylene coupler. Or we can have the failure in the fusion plane. This is the area where the pipe and the coupler are fused. When we have uncontaminated electrofusion joints and they are tested in this way, we find at the reference weld without flaws that the failure is totally in the coupler. This is one part of the coupler, this is the other part of the coupler, and here we have the wires. Here have been the wires, they are now not in this parts. In contrary to the reference welds, where we have the failure in the wire plane, we find that the flaw, the tight contamination, produces the failure in the fusion plane. This is the reason why we see the blue pipe surface and the surface, the inner surface of the coupler. So it's very similar to the butt welded joints, that the failure behavior can be related to the contamination situation. There are other tests, internal pressure tests on welded pipes or joint pipes with electrofusion joints, and one of the flaw was to produce a cold weld with reduced energy during the welding. The result of this internal pressure test on this sample was a leakage during filling of the sample. So it's there was no need to make additional investigations. These tests were done according to ISO 1167, which describes the internal pressure tests on pipeline systems. Another flaw is the so-called under-penetration. And these samples were also tested by using internal pressure tests. When we removed the samples from the test after failure, we see at the outside of the coupler a crack, which is indicated by these arrows. The crack is orientated in circumferential direction of the coupler and obviously is outside the middle of the coupler. It's a little bit orientated to the right side of in this slide. When we cut the joint, we can see that this pipe is not at the stop end. This pipe is touching the stop end, and this displacement from the pipe or from the stop end is called under penetration. This under penetration causes a crack starting from one of the wires in the coupler, and this crack is traveling to the outside of the coupler. When we open the fracture surfaces of the coupler, we can see some steps. And these steps are related to the stepwise traveling of the crack due to the fibrils at the crack tip, and this is a typical fracture appearance of slow crack growth in polyethylene. Now I'm coming to the evaluation of the flaws, the evaluation related to the results of the mechanical tests. When we consider talc contamination at butt welds, we can say that talc contamination is not acceptable for all levels of contamination chosen in this project, light, medium and heavy. The same result we get for the electrofusion welds. In both cases we have fracture in the fusion level. We have a high scattering of the test results, and these two reasons do not allow to transfer the results get at higher temperatures and accelerated conditions to the service conditions. So these contaminations are not acceptable from our point of view. The cold welds, okay, they leaked during the test, are obviously not acceptable. And a special situation we have at the under penetration at the F joints, the crack in the couplers before they have reached the required testing time of the relevant standard are not acceptable. But these results are related to the couplers chosen in this project. I thank you for your attention.